So speak up for me. Why don't you guys tell me a little bit about what that was like?
I very heavily rely on my sense of vision. That is not easy and not comfortable. Fortunately though, wave action's pretty small. So you can take a wave twice, like if it surprises you and it's not the end of the world. First time doing that.
What about you, Cameron?
I definitely agree with what Jacob had to say. When I went out there that time with my eyes closed, no vision at all, kind of have to rely on your other senses, so it's good to practice with them.
No, but guys, I mean, like, seriously, I appreciate you giving me an ad, but what was it like? Did those waves sound a lot bigger than they were?
They sound a lot bigger than they were.
Yeah. Fortunately, we had gone out before, so we kind of knew what to expect. But you're in the surf, and
once you clear the break zone, it's just like weird swimming with your eyes closed, with no waves necessarily hitting you. It's like
you don't really know.
Feeling like you're swimming forever.
You don't know which direction they're coming from, so you could be swimming parallel to shore or offshore.
How many times did I blow the whistle for you guys to come in?
You must have blown it at least 3 times. I didn't hear it until the last one.
I heard it the second time.
No, you did not.
I did?
No, you did not. I had to blow the whistle 4 times just for you, Cameron. That's my point, guys.
Yeah.
So the reason that we're doing this now is look at how small this wave action is. And you see how hard it is to communicate? Now, obviously, I'm not blowing hard, but this can put out 115 decibels, right? This is the loudest whistle I can get. So if this don't work, we're fucked. All right, you guys ready to keep going?
Yeah.